Hello everyone, welcome to my free online tutorial for the new SAT Math section. This is problem number 37, practice test 4, section 4, calculator allowed. And this practice test is found in the new SAT official study guide, okay? So the stock price of one share in a certain company is worth $360 today. A stock analyst believes that the stock will lose 28% of its value each week for the next 3 weeks. The analyst uses the equation V is equal to 360 times R raised to the t-th power to model the value V of the stock after T weeks. Okay, so what value should the analyst use for R? So my technique would be to find the value of the stock in 1 week's time, right? So after 1 week passes, what will be the value of the stock? So we're told that 360 is the original price of one share of the stock, right? So 360, and then it's going to lose 28% by the end of the first week, right? So 28% loss means that in value we multiply the 360 by 1 minus 0.28. Why? Because 100% of 360 in value is 360 times 1, right? And 28% is 28 divided by 100 times 360, right? So that's why we subtract 0.28, because 0.28 once again is 28 divided by 100, right? So we subtract that from 1 because we're losing 28%, all right? So if you do this properly, you will have 0.72, right? So which means that 72% of the $360 remains as a price of the stock after 1 week's time, right? So that's why you multiply 360 by 0.72. Now, the same thing for week 2. Now we take this current value, 360 times 0.72, and we're losing 28% of this new value by the end of the second week, right? So we do the same thing. So we have 360 times 0.72 times 0.72, and guess what this means? This means that we can express it as 360 times 0.72 raised to the second power, right? Because this is squared. Now notice something very interesting. Notice that the week number matches the number in the power for 0.72. Like for week 1, it's to the first power, that's why we don't write it in. For week 2, it's raised to the second power, right? The 72% that's left. Now let's keep going. Now week 3, we have 360, right? The current value, which is 360 times 0.72 squared, right? And we take 28% off of that by the third week, right? Because it keeps losing 28% of the current value. So we subtract 28% one more time, and we have 360 times 0.72 squared times 0.72. And that means that the 0.72 is raised to the cubic power, right? Because we have 3 instances of the 0.72 in the products. So that means that 360 is multiplying the 0.72 raised to the cubic power, to the power of 3, right? And once again, this tendency that we noticed regarding the week number and the power number remains there, right? It still shows us that there's a link between these two. Okay, now, for this reason, we can use the weak T, right? Because we know that the weak number and the current value power is exactly one integer less than the weak number. So for this, using the same logic, we use the weak T, right? Because we're asked to find the value that the analyst used for R. And why do we need to, how do we estimate R? Well, because we have to develop the formula for the T, and then we'll know what the R is, right? So which is why we jump to weak T. So once again, weak T means that this current value power, right, the current value power here will be one integer less, right? Because here 2 was exactly one integer less than the weak number here, so which is why 0.72 is raised to the T minus 1 power, right? And again, by the end of this week, weak T, 28% will be lost from the T minus 1th week, right? So we're going to have 360 times 0.72 raised to the T minus 1 power and multiplying that with 0.72. And what does this mean? If you're good with the exponents, if you know how to manipulate, you should know that this means 360 times 0.72 raised to t minus 1 plus 1. Why plus 1? Because this 0.72 is raised to the first power. And when you have the same term, 0.72, their powers, when you have the same numbers raised to different powers, basically what happens is their powers are simply summed up, right? They add, which is why 0.72 has a t minus 1 power times 0.72 is equal to 0.72 raised to the t minus 1 plus 1, right? You simply added their exponents together, right? And you had one base, only one base, which is 0.72. So as a result, you will have t minus 1 plus 1, which is simply equal to t for the power for 0.72, because minus 1 and plus 1 is just equal to 0, right? So that's why your final answer will be 360 times 0.72 raised to the t-th power. Now you're ready to find the value of r, because this expression now has a t as a power, just as a t here in the power is shown in the original problem, right? So you set them equal, and you know, notice the correlation here, that 360 is the same, 360 is the same, right? And that means logically that 0.72 is the value of r here, right? Because everything else is the same. If you were to divide both sides by 360, you would have 0.72 raised to the t-th power, and the base r must be equal to 0.72. However, since the r is equal to 0.72, if you're taking a paper test, you cannot use the zero before your decimal, right? So you have to exclude it, right? So you have to grid your answer as 0.72. So you have to use three characters, all right? 0.72.